Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to the Elder Scrolls 2 Daggerfall. This will essentially be our very last video of Daggerfall in DOS. And, the entire reason that I'm making this video is because of the Lord K'avar Questline, which is initiated right now. Now, the thing is, the Lord K'avar Questline is a very infamous questline in the Fighters Guild. And I honestly want to address it because with my next playthroughs of Daggerfall, I will not be touching the Fighter Skill at all. And to that effect, I've actually installed the CompUSA patch, which gives me additional missions. I just completed Standard Protection as well, and that was pretty entertaining mission, to be honest. Quite a different taste compared to the standard Fighter Skill missions that we've been sent to thus far. Very entertaining, actually. Very engaging. Anyhow, this is the mission that we have been looking forward to. And I honestly don't know how it's gonna go. Maybe we'll have to wait for letters to arrive in between, you know, sessions. But yeah, so this is Lord K'avar part 1, and of course I will be packing all the parts into this one video. So Grimfangs, I have an important mission that will require the utmost discretion. I can't tell you more unless you agree to help me. What do you say? Yes. An old friend of mine is in grave danger and needs an escort who is handy with a blade and can keep a secret. Naturally, I thought of you. Thank you. Tristester Moorsmith will meet you at 10 tonight at the Vicroft residence. He will tell you more when you arrive. I would come with you, but since I am known as his friend, I might lead his enemies to him. Watch your back on this one. Vicroft residence. Alright. Huh. Let us talk to you. I want to know location general, maybe? General Vicroft residence. Is a ways west of here, right? Now, one of the ways that this quest can bug out is if you essentially, while you're on a horse, you get teleported. You tend to get teleported indoors sometime from time to time if you're on a horse. So yeah, that's one of the ways that this quest can bug out. So it would be wise to take care and make sure that such a situation never arises. What else do we want to equip? This mark, which we don't know what it does. It does something, we just don't know what it does. Maybe this as well. Since we have an open slot, I mean. So yeah, this Warlock's Ring, when you wear it, it gives you feet of Ntorgok. So it will make the ring go way faster, but since we are only waiting for like just a, you know, few sequences of dungeon crawls, I'm not really that afraid of it, so to speak. Anyhow, it makes a super fast though, which is essentially amazing. I would like to equip my sword for this one. Alright, what is the time right now? It is 8:22 and at 10 tonight. Okay, so basically, how long do we loiter here? We can loiter here for like 2 hours. And let us go look for a place to pull up, maybe, because loitering around outside is not gonna help. We can probably like spend some time here in this tavern, and yeah, you guys can see how fast we're running. Who is this guy? Damn. Anyhow, sorry. Yes, food and drinks. I would like some meat and a room for one day. Room is free for a night such as myself. Of course it is. The time right now would be 10:27, so consequently I would like to rest for not 12, but rather, let's say, 10 hours. And with that, give me some time, please. And it is at this point that I accidentally stopped recording sounds in this game. And yeah, so like I muted my mic and forgot to unmute it. So that was pretty much on me. However, I'm going to try and I was looking at this guy because of his unique appearance with the whip and everything. and we go over to the contact's house and make an attempt to perhaps enter the house, but what we forgot was the fact that doors close during the night. We have to head east at this point. Yeah, that houses are closed at night. We can't exactly enter houses just like that. So as you guys saw, it's about 9:30-ish, and I'm trying to enter the house because the appointment time is at 10 o'clock. However, yeah, we probably should have entered during the evening and just stayed inside overnight, because it does not work that way. So yeah, I'm going to lodge here for like an hour. Should be 9:30 now. And yeah, it's 9:30. We're trying to enter the house, but it is locked. And so at this point, we're wondering whether it would be worth the price to pay if we were to knock the door down. And we ultimately weigh the pros and cons, given the fact that we have already completed the game, and we are honestly just playing this mission for the sake of playing this mission, and we decide to bash the door down anyway. And that is what we do. Bash the door down. And the speed of a weapon, by the way, is because of the feet of the toggle, and there are guards on us at this point in time. Guards that we need to take care of. And only two guards, to be honest, and we continue bashing him. That's all we do, just bash away. And it ultimately leads us into the home. Now, there are three doors here, nothing in two of those doors, and one of the doors is locked, magically held by a lock. And we have no choice but to, you know, open it using an open spell with our, you know, Shirt of Undeniable Access, Long Shirt of Undeniable Access. We first tried looking for anything in the environment which we could have used to essentially open the lock, but we could not find anything because the door was just magically locked for whatever reason, and we had to unlock it using magic, using the open spell. So that is exactly what we did. Typically, cabinets and stuff like that are supposed to be pilferable, but not in this case. So yeah. Pretty much that. We head upstairs, but we unfortunately find nothing there. At this point, we're beginning to wonder whether this quest is even, you know, something that can be completed. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. Let's get up there. And there's literally nothing here. Nobody here. So I'm just sitting around at this point. Of course, I can carry in more stuff because I'm overburdened as is. And I'm trying to touch this lamp when suddenly an apparition appears in front of me. And this is the contact. Because it's 10. Apparently later on they found out that you can actually wait until... This guy actually waits until 12 o'clock, so you're cool to stay in here for longer. You're Grimfangs. Tristisir Greenham described you well. I'm Tristisir Moorsmith. We must proceed to Sentinel at once. I can tell you no more except that the enemies of Queen Akorithi would give much to stop us. As they do. As they do. Which you shall figure out soon. Now this is the part of the quest which is actually interesting. The rest of the quest just goes downhill quickly from here. This guy is in our inventory now, and well, we exit as soon as possible. Tristisir Moorsmith gasps, and you turn to see a feathered shaft protruding from his chest. As he sinks to his knees, he slips a letter in your hand and murmurs, "Lord K'avar is a traitor to Sentinel. You must get this to Queen Akorithi. Tristisir Moorsmith is dead." And yeah, so at this point, our objective is pretty simple. We need to head. Yeah, we're also getting attacked by some of these guys. The Warlock's Ring, though, it gives you like a massive speed boost. So at this point, our objective is pretty simple. Just go ahead and fight as many of these. Turn the letter over to Queen Akorithi of Sentinel, and we're golden. And yeah, I like that Waldron because it has a golden trim to it. So I try to, you know, put it into my inventory, failing of course to do so. And I don't know why I didn't just put the right Waldron into my inventory itself, but I guess I just didn't care about things much at this point, since this is essentially the endgame scenario. So yeah, I finally managed to equip it, and we are about to head to... We're still looking for Daedric, or at least Ebony Gauntlets, if we can find them. Anything better than Mithril, that is. But, of course, to no avail, we cannot find anything of that sort. We already have, like, an Orcish cuirass. This is... It's just a matter of completion of set at this point, and nothing else apart from that. But, anyhow... we try to make a run for it, or rather travel to Queen Sentinel, to Queen Akorathian Sentinel, except we cannot travel when enemies are nearby, so we just find the last enemy and slay them, which is apparently another archer, one of Lord K'avar's men, women in this case, and not the connotation that I wanted to display there, but yeah. Before we travel, a small child of indeterminate gender hands you a note and runs away before you have a chance to react. And that happened. So, we open the note to figure out, to read something there. Intelligence. Yeah, I was wondering why my intelligence is high. I wonder if that's something that the Warlock's Ring does for us. Or maybe the dragonish, you know, thing. Anyway, dear Grimfangs, change of plans. Just as your Greenham has had to leave town quickly and asked me to meet you in the Silver Griffin. Please come at once. The matter is extremely urgent. Rochester moving. Now, as far as this letter was concerned, you were supposed to receive this before actually going to meet your sister Greenham. This letter arrived to us late, and if you had received this letter and went ahead and met the contact, he would have given you an amulet to wear, which would teleport you to a random dungeon so in order to stop you, slow down your progress. And until then is the point where, you know, the plot is actually quite topsy-turvy, but then it sort of becomes a dull dungeon crawl after that. But for now, we're just sort of figuring out that just as you're Greenham, we already met that guy. So the assertion that he had to leave town quickly and asked Rochester, or somebody rather who is posing as Rochester, to meet us in a tavern must be false, because we have already met him. We have his corpse right beside us. So, yeah, at this point we have not read the letter given unto us by, you know, Chester Greenham, or Moosmith, whatever his name was. I sort of forgot. I'm bad with names that way. But, yeah. So we head over to Sentinel, we decide that perhaps it's just best to give Queen Akorathi the letter, and we head over to Sentinel. We check around for any foes that might try to attack us. Because while playing standard protection, I got attacked by some, you know, sentries of Sentinel. some people from the Order of the Candle here to do us in. And I installed the Red Guard mod, so they are actually looking like Red Guards this time around. It is at this, shortly after this point, that I realized that I forgot to start recording. And yeah, that is where I sort of... Here is where I sort of decide to start reading this letter, and I realize that I forgot to start recording. So I'll just cut over to when I realize that I've forgotten to start recording. And yeah, I'll just let the other me take over at this point. Thank you for listening in. So... Yeah, let me begin from the very top here. My dear Rochester Moving, I am pleased to hear of your progress in training my forces at the Haunt of Balthanon. I will send more money as soon as I can raise it, as you will need to hire more troops if we hope to defeat Queen Akorathi. You are surely correct that going into open battle against her is a lost cause, but I believe that even for a coup de main against the castle itself, we will need more men. Now here's the thing, I don't really know the difference between coup d'etat and coup de main. I think one of them is like an overthrow of the government, like you overtake the government, but I think this coup de main means more about... I don't know, I'm just guessing it, but I think it's more about laying siege to something? Anyhow, we can discuss this matter further in person when I arrive at the Haunt of Balthanon in a few weeks. If you need to reach me in the meantime, I'm staying in the palace at Vancastle Garden. If all goes well, we may soon have a new ally. Once the situation here is proceeding smoothly again, I must return to Sentinel to pay my respects, perhaps my final respects, to our dear Queen. Her agents have been dogging my steps lately, so I shall allay her suspicions by a show of fawning subservience, which she so appreciates. Keep me informed of your progress. Most sincerely, Lord K'avar, Van Castle Garden. Now here's the thing. Lord K'avar actually wrote this letter to Rodister Moving. I don't know to what extent Rodister Moving is involved. Maybe he's acting as sort of a double agent, but... I mean, he probably is acting as sort of a double agent, and maybe we have to go meet him. But I feel like delivering this message directly to Queen Akorathi might be the better choice here, given the urgency of it, the nature of the letter, and it's a pretty urgent thing. We shouldn't exactly dally around with it. We can, if this doesn't work out, if the game just wants me to go ahead and meet the other person, maybe we'll just go ahead and reload the old save. The way to Queen Akorathi's chamber is also pretty... well, convoluted, so to speak. But one of the things that I like about Castle Sentinel is that you can, like, literally free-roam it to a great extent. You can free-roam it. The guards never attack you or stop you from going anywhere in this castle. The only reason I'm walking so fast is because of the feat of Notargo cast on me by the Warlock's Ring. Queen Akorathi, I assume. You seem like a Queen Akorathi. Yes, you are. Even though you look more like Queen Elizabeth of England. But, okay. Do you give the treasonous letter to Queen Akorathi? Yes, I do. Yes, what's this letter? Dear RK, Lord K'avar is plotting against me? Guards, search the castle for Lord K'avar and bring him to me at once. Several guards run from the room. A few minutes later, one returns. With a salute, he reports that Lord K'avar is nowhere to be found. Queen Akorathi turns to you. He must have been alerted that his treason was about to be uncovered. Most likely, he has retired to this haunt of Balthanon he refers to in this letter. In his letter, under the circumstances, I would prefer to avoid a direct attack. You are familiar with the area, yes? Will you perform one more service for me and bring this traitor to justice? Sure. Grimfangs, you are proving most loyal to the throne of Sentinel. I will wait 41 days before assaulting Lord K'avar's fortress. I hereby proclaim Lord K'avar outlaw. Capture him if you can, but kill him if you must. Grimfangs, welcome to Sentinel. I trust you've had a comfortable stay so far. Let me... oh, right. Apparently this quest is still active. Trusted Nord. For your sword, I'm willing to pay 560 gold with future castle gains to recover Nadum for the late king. I shall have to rethink your standing in this court. Yeah, that was a cue for one of the mainline quests, which would have ultimately, after we had completed a few other quests, gotten us the location of Lysander's tomb from the King of Worms. Not the King of Worms, the Underking. But since we are not allying ourselves with Castle Sentinel in this playthrough, we are not going to be addressing that. Instead, we will head back outside of this castle and head straight towards the haunt of Balthanon. No, not really. Waiting for it to load. I met with Trisister Moosmith and we're proceeding to Central. Grasta Residence? That, we never went with Grasta Residence, it was something else. Anyway, before we died, he sent me a letter. I showed the treason set up, but Lord K'avar had already. Haunt of Balthanon. Yeah. Alright. Presumably it's in Central. Haunt of Balthanon. Maybe just Haunt of Balthanon? Okay. Balthanon. Did I get the spelling wrong or something? The Haunt of Balthanon. Yeah, that's the name. Infiltrate the fortress and capture or kill Lord K'avar. So where is the Haunt of Balthanon? But I'm assuming it's somewhere in Sentinel. Haunt of Balthanon. No? Am I getting the spelling wrong or something? The Haunt of... Yeah. B-A-L-T-H-E-N-O-N. Fortress of the Haunt of Balthanon? What's going on? Is it like somewhere in... Verus, perhaps? Because these two places are at in a constant state of fighting. I'm over there. Yes. Nothing here apparently. It's gonna be difficult to find. Okay. Clerba Quiltus? I don't know how that... Various crypts of... Yeah, these are just minor crypts. Not exactly any haunts, so to speak. Is that the Haunt of Balthanon? No, that's Castle Farlem. Why did we go to Castle Farlem again? Well, I think it was because... Prince Luton sent us there. I don't know why this is marked on a map though. Haunt of Balthanon. K'avar. Okay, let's try Fortress of the Haunt of Balthanon. Okay. That did not work. Lots of homes here. So, where am I supposed to go? And just give me a moment there. So, apparently, Haunt of Balthanon should be in Koegria. Was wondering why the name sounds so familiar. Because, well, we have been there before. Look at our equip speed. I hope this is where Lord K'avar is, to be honest. Because if he's not here, then it's gonna be... Well, difficult for us. And if, like, he's in Pancastle Garden instead. Oh, this place. Time to clear out this side first. Not an awfully large dungeon, to be honest. Okay, time to pop in a potion of resist shock. Just as I said, it was not too difficult a dungeon, I can hear. A vampire ancient, of all things. Where's resist shock? Am I out of resist shock? I think I am. Oh no. Yep, I'm out of resist shock. I've got no resist shock. Potions of resist shock. Okay, Warlock's ring it is, I suppose. For as far as it lasts, I think this is going to take us back up to the top. Yes, it does. Which makes no sense. We'll go back down and clear out the path at the bottom first. Shit. Towards the right here, this guy gave me a jump scare. Like, with this thing, I can literally just unlock enemies. Is this the... Yeah. The falsified letter. And... I hear more vampire ancients. Sorry, I was about to say I hear more vampires, but what came out of my mouth was vampire ancients. I did not mean to say vampire ancients, I meant to say vampires. I hear more vampires, and is this all there is to this section then? Any hidden doors? Apparently not, just this section. So this is actually an even smaller module than I remember it be. I think that's a ghost. Shadow Door's mirror is an effective spell. We should keep it active for as long as possible. I don't know if whether it's like a passive effect or like an active effect, but yeah. There is also a hidden door here. I doubt Lord K'avar will be behind it. Because, oh shit, I forgot to do the most important thing. The one thing that you're supposed to do as soon as you enter this dungeon module. Flip this time switch. The enemies seem lesser in number though. Which is, I suppose, a good thing. Excuse me. Can I pick it up now? Thank you. I'm just checking for any Daedric Gauntlets at this point. Or even Ebony or Adamantium books. Orcish is also welcome, to be honest. Okay, let us go ahead and use this ring here. We'll keep topping ourselves off. Yeah, it took way too many swings because I was not in range. But well, I am in range now. So suck that, suck on that. Should be, yeah, another one down there. So Shadow's mirror is amazing because, ooh, what is this? Tar shield, yeah, just a +4 armor rating, just looks blue as all. Nothing specifically special about it. Anything behind this door? No. But most likely there is something behind this door. A hallway. Okay, another similar arrangement. I think there's another hallway here. This way, if I recall correctly, anyway. Okay. I think this was dead in this room. Wraith is dead. More wraiths. Now, typically this room... Oh yeah, it does have like a slight thing. But this room typically does end in a dead end, but not always. Typically. Just typically. That's a vampire. My attack speed, my god. Should I? Might as well, right? Let us go ahead and not like this, but yeah, like this. Use the Warlock String again just to give us some semblance of protection. Good thing that we cleared this out. I don't think there is like a hidden door or anything down here. Not that I recall. We have been here before to this very dungeon. Looking for giants, I do believe, if I'm not wrong. For one of the fighter skill quests. Skelly, what are you doing here? There's a vampire in there, but I don't know if there's like Lord K'avar in there. We'll go check that area out later. Now sometimes... I don't know what that does, but that did something. Yeah, so sometimes you can come in through this door here, and when that happens... Oh, it's this module. This of course will not do anything, but in case it does something, I'll just... can't save in the emergency slot, I'll just save over this slot since I've exhausted its use. Is that like multiple ones? Of course, I'm paralyzed. Free action, free action, free action. Free action. Where is it? where are you? Free action. I'm pretty sure we had a few potions of free action. I'm just trying to figure out where they are. Okay, boots. Magic boots of free action. Tall boots, rather. Vampire Ancient is dead. This area should lead us to a dead end. My... yeah. Warlock's ring is about to go out, and I would rather keep it stacked. Like, the spell effects won't stack, but it will increase the duration of your spell. Vampire Ancient is dead. Let's just go ahead and use like a potion of healing, since we have plenty of those anyway. Hi. Nobody here except for this one guy. Spell was reflected. Even though we did get hurt, we didn't take the like full amount of damage there. A hidden door. Thank you for opening it for us. Vampire Ancient is dead. Like, the Warlock's ring can also... oh, right. I've completely forgot about this. The Warlock's ring is also capable of... we need to flip the switch here to unlock that little gate at the end. So, the Warlock's ring can actually heal you as well, so even if you run out of healing potions and don't really have a place to rest, it's not really that big of an issue. Now, there are a few... what's that lever there? I think it just raises and lowers the gate. This will take us upstairs, if I'm not wrong. Nothing in here. Gnaw dog, he will pay for your meddling in Lord K'avar's affairs. Archer, okay. I might be going the right way then, if these guys decide to show up. Just need to figure out which is the right way. I recall this not being such a large dungeon. Skelly. I don't know why the skeletons scream so in this game. But I suppose they have always been screaming. Bloody murder. Or maybe freedom, if depending upon whether it's a Scottish skeleton or not, in every single game, anyway. This module also seems quite familiar. Oh no. It's one of those teleportation modules. Oh no. Actually, I don't want to save there. Yep, this teleported us somewhere. What just happened? I was wondering where the ghost is that is guarding this area, because this is like a 1:1 copy of that place. What's his name? Lysander's tomb. This interaction, I mean. Okay, I should have saved there a long time ago, but I did not because I was sort of overconfident. And now at least we know the way out, so... just marking this place as having been visited. Seriously? No. We're still there. We are still there. And no Lord K'avar here. Well, I suppose that's good. Unless he's supposed to spawn into a location. Just like his lackeys are. Maybe we don't actually need to... scout the dungeon for him. Let's try that. Let's try resting in the same place until, you know, all these lackeys, including Lord K'avar, just randomly shows up. Let's try that. because no way in hell is one of his lackeys coming all the way here. So maybe we'll just try doing that then. It spawned us here. There's another teleporter door here. I don't know whether it is actually a teleporter door. No, seems like just a bricked up wall, to be honest. Not there, I keep defaulting to that safe. Yeah, we can't really go through it or anything. Let alone touch it. Now, what we can do is we can just rest here. I'm first gonna rest until I'm fully healed. And then I'm gonna loiter for like 3 hours. There are enemies nearby? Okay. Where's the enemy? That's another one of Lord K'avar's archers. I'm honestly just looking for some Daedric Greaves. Even Orcish or Ebony ones are welcome at this point. Not Greaves, sorry, Gauntlets. Right, and I think that is the formula here. We just keep loitering until Lord K'avar shows up. No need to actually explore this dungeon. Because see, the thing is, if that is true, like if we don't need to actually search the dungeon to find Lord K'avar, then we would essentially be wasting our time by searching the dungeon. So might as well just loiter around here until all he shows up, after all his lackeys do. I guess it's not working the way I intended it, but yeah, sometimes you need to move a little before the effects kick in. So might as well explore the dungeon a little more in the process. And see what else we can find here. Another lackey! Unless these are just dungeon denizens of the dungeon, I suppose. Seems unlikely though. Seems highly unlikely. Let's try loitering here, since we did find that lackey. Typically, you would be able to find like an enemy spawning in your location within like the first 3 loiters. Sometimes when you're done loitering, an enemy will show up. Yep. Not there. Here? Where's the enemy? I'm waiting upon the enemy, come on. Where's the enemy? You lied to me, there's no enemy there. I mean, I do have time to waste, so like I've got 41 days in total to waste. Now here's the thing, it says there are enemies nearby again, but I don't know where the enemies are. I guess I'll just proceed along this way. Ah, there you are, Archer. You're not supposed to be here. Have we already been here? Yes, we have. This is the way we came in. And right then, so we can take a left, like we can go back up and explore the other side that we didn't explore this way here. I'm unsure of whether this quest works the way I think it works, being the reason why I'm electing to actually explore it, the dungeon. Because sometimes the archers spawn in on your location, sometimes they don't. And the entire reason that I'm thinking that the archers... Holy shit. Should have been saving far more often, actually. That was on me. That was entirely on me. and should have been equipping Shadow's Ring. Sorry, the Warlock's Ring. I think this is the way we came from. There's an archer in here. Should be just a vampire in here. And nothing else. Right then. Let us rest until we're fully healed here. Enemies nearby. Wait, let me just go ahead and reuse this ring. And then we can go ahead and save here. A rat disturbed my sleep is what did. Anyway, rest until fully healed. I'm healed. Resave this game here. We have already explored this side. Right then. I'm still half convinced that... Oh wait, totally forgot. Have to reuse this ring. I'm still half convinced that I just have to wait around until the enemy show. Which I think is the way to play this. I'm paralyzed, of course I am. Tall boots of... Unrestrainable tall boots. Die, bitch. How dare you attack me? With your filthy little mittens. I don't technically need to do this because this ring will heal nonetheless, but yeah, I still like to do that. Nothing here either, so we can go back up. And essentially go back the way we came from. Retrace our steps, basically. Although, I suppose we could have taken a shortcut through that door there instead of coming all the way here. Yeah, this leads us to essentially the same place. Went around the long way for no reason. So, yeah, we take a left here and I think. Yes, we take a left here and just keep going straight. Straight? Straight. So Lord K'avar is definitely not anywhere underwater, that much for sure. What we need to figure out is where he is though. A vampire ancient? Come on. You don't get to go stun locked on me. And stop attacking me. Stay in my range. Fight like a man. Fight like what you once were before you turned yourself into a monstrosity. I just wish these enchanted items would last longer, because right now, that is effectively my only lifeline. Skeletal warrior died. This essentially opens back into the main area. What is that thing over there? Something over there. No longer visible now. I'll be jumping down there, don't worry about it. I will be jumping down there, but... Alright, time to head down lower. Come on. You're a vampire, what are you afraid of? I won't bite. Oh yeah, I totally forgot about this little room here. That was a she-archer, a female archer. Yeah, the objective could be here actually. I think this was one of the areas where the objective could have been. This is where we found the Daggerfall in one of the quests for the Daggerfall. Oh, this is where it comes out, I see. So all of this and thus far, no Lord K'avar. Could be that we have missed like a few hidden doors perhaps somewhere, or maybe we haven't explored the place in its entirety, but yeah, it seems strange that... Time to reuse the ring. Yeah, sorry about that. But yeah, so where are we supposed to go again? We haven't explored further down there. Maybe we can do that. Maybe we can explore further down the point. We did check towards this side of the place. There was nothing but like an empty wall there, so yeah, I suppose we just keep going down. Maybe we'll find Lord K'avar, or we'll definitely find something. And once the entire area has been cleared of hostiles, I think that's where we came from, right? And I'm quite certain that Lord K'avar will not be underwater. Have we explored that side in its entirety though? I do think we have. That just leads out to the main area. And if Lord K'avar isn't down here, then it's just a matter of waiting around until he comes to us, essentially. But that's a vampire ancient in there from the looks of it. Alright, here we go. Okay, time to use like a... We do have like a... Yeah, I don't think we can use it like that. We... Water breathing and water walking, perhaps. If it is available to us. It makes movement speed inside water very fast. Otherwise, we will just be trudging along like nobody's business. Slaughter fish, probably. No, an archer underwater of all places. Why, I wonder. Okay, this door open first. But all that is here is a ghost. No backstab though. Skellies. It's like a huge spawn right here. Excuse me. I would kindly request you all to die. Thank you. No Lord K'avar in the cage. No Lord K'avar in here. And that's honestly all there is under the water, I mean. Nothing else here under the water. Unless I'm missing something. Which I don't think I am. But yeah, there's literally nothing else under the water. So, let's get out and confirm once, but I think at this point we have explored the entirety of the dungeon and found no Lord K'avar whatsoever. So if that is the case, then all we can do at this point is just wait. Just wait it out. Have you been on top of this? Yes, we have. So I guess it's just a matter of waiting things out. Because we've been to the teleporter area as well and no Lord K'avar there. And then there was this place. Don't think there are any other places that can be explored. Okay. At this point, we have explored that. Have we explored these areas? Could be that Lord K'avar isn't here at all. We just had to go to Van Castle Garden instead. If that was the case, it would have been like pretty easy, to be honest. But actually, I think I have been to Van Castle Garden before. And there's not much there, to be honest. Oh, right! Yeah. We haven't been here yet. Let's go ahead and clear that area out then. While we wait for Lord K'avar to show up anyway. Oh, sorry. I wanted to rest until fully healed. I've cleared this area out of enemies, so I can pretty much just heal there pretty easily. I don't know why my intelligence just keeps going up. I mean, what has pretty much cursed me with intelligence at this point. Let me go ahead and save, because I have not saved in a while. Do you want to go there or do you want to go straight? Let's go here. Cheater. Not exactly cheater, but a sneak. He gave me a sneak attack. Yeah, this is gonna take us to an arena. One of the pieces, one of the layouts in this dungeon module that I dislike. Actually, it did not. It just brought us out over here. Lord K'avar could very well be down there, actually. Let's clean out the other side too. We don't need to slide down because there is a way down for us. We just need to go to the other side of... Lord K'avar could very well be down there, actually. Or in any number of the places upstairs. This will take us downstairs. Let's clear out the area downstairs and come back up to check where Lord K'avar might be. Pretty sure there's a vampire ancient up ahead. Yep. This door is always safeguarded by the most difficult enemy there is in the game. Like this passage right here. Which is not to say that the rest of the area is not safeguarded by difficult enemies, but there are difficult enemies. The entrance to the area is definitely safeguarded by a difficult enemy. Okay, unrestrainable tall boots. And the warlock string. Because why not? You know what? Right, then. Fuck you. There's like an extra area here. Surrender and be dragged through the streets of Sentinel as a public spectacle? Never! Lord K'avar is dead. Well then, I guess this will be a one-part series then. For us at least. Because I suppose I should have told Akorithi no when she gave us the opportunity to capture or kill him. Yeah. Sort of anticlimactic there. But, well, it is what it is, I suppose. It is what it is. Because otherwise this series of quests would have been far more engaging, in my opinion, if I had just, you know, said no to her at that point. I could just do that right now, to be honest. And have the fun of exploring this dungeon and killing Lord K'avar, as well as, you know, seeking him out and killing him later again. No. No, I do not. Alright. Back to Sentinel it is. Horse. Sentinel. Sentinel. Yeah, yeah. I mean, we have sufficient amount of days left at this point, I do believe. This was sort of anticlimactic, and I do believe the fault lays on me this time around, because I should have probably declined killing or the chance to kill or capture Lord K'avar. I mean, we can still do that. We can still do that, to be honest. Because they're like, if we had denied capturing him, we would have gotten like... this would have spawned out to like three entire missions. Three, instead of just one. But I swear, like, the Warlock's Ring is insanely powerful. Alright, time to report back to Queen Akorithi then. Let's see what she has to say. Huh. All right, Queen. I have killed your traitor. So be it. Lord K'avar chose his course and paid the consequences. Thanks to you. Here is an enchanted ripe pauldron for your service to Sentinel. I'm assuming it got added to my inventory. Oh yeah, right. Steel ripe pauldron, arsenal. I'll just put it into my wagon. Oh right, I cannot access my wagon from inside what is considered a dungeon. Not that it matters, because I'm gonna go ahead and loot this safe anyway. Alright, so I was trying to do this quest, the Lord K'avar quest, and the thing is, it just isn't entertaining enough for me. I mean, on paper it sounds like one of those thrilling plot lines for the kind of thrilling plot lines and twists that full of twists and turns that Daggerfall throws at you. However, once you actually sit to playing the game, it's pretty straightforward and a very standard dungeon crawl. So you've got two choices essentially right now, as we have received this letter. And the first choice is to, well, we can either talk to Queen Nagorathi and give her the letter, or we can talk to Lord K'avar and give him the letter. In case we give the letter to Queen Nagorathi, well, she will give us the opportunity to find and kill Lord K'avar, and when we succeed, that's the end of the game there. However, if we give Lord K'avar the letter, I am assuming it will tell us it will give us an opportunity to fight him or to ally with him. And I think if we choose to ally with him, then in that event, well, it will branch the storyline off into a different direction. So basically, if we ally with Lord K'avar, it will launch Lord K'avar Part 2, wherein we have to find Lord K'avar in, well, Castle Central, where he's held captive and is set for execution, and we have to find him and free him. However, if we choose to give the letter to Agorathi and we refuse to help her find Lord K'avar, she's anyway going to, you know, call upon us later and ask us to find Lord K'avar, who is currently hiding out in Castle Verest, and bring him back to her for execution. So yeah, it's like a standard dungeon crawl either way, and the castle dungeons are huge sprawling mazes full of magical traps and contraptions, which at this point I've honestly grown sick and tired of. So yeah, and here I was thinking that maybe it's a collection of three quests that spawn into something beautiful, because when I had looked into it earlier, it turned out that, well, first we try to capture him or kill him, and then we save him, which is part 2, as it is presented in the Unofficial Elder Scrolls Pages, and that part 3 would be capturing him for execution again. So it sort of made me think that this might just be part of a huge sprawling plotline, and I didn't really want to spoil it too much for myself, being the reason why I was so excited to play it, but when I actually sat to playing it, it's, well, pretty standard and lackluster, to be honest. So yeah, I suppose that's that. I mean, standard protection was a far more interesting experience, in my opinion. Far more interesting experience, because of all the, you know, all the ways the plot had twists and turns in it. But anyhow, let's get out of this tavern here. And for a final video of the Elder Scrolls to Daggerfall, at least as far as the tossbox is concerned, this is pretty much it. The Steam version, I mean, we did make a few modifications to it here and there, but this is it. There will be no more videos for the Elder Scrolls Daggerfall, DOS at least. I will be returning to the game, playing it on Unity, but that will come at a later point in time. For now, I don't want to see this game anymore. I'm tired of crawling dungeons, and I'm gonna take a healthy break from Daggerfall for the time being. Before, of course, I will return to it, and I'm not planning on using smaller dungeons, but let's see. Let's see what a mood says at that time, because honestly, it's an option which can be turned off and on freely, so we don't really need to bother ourselves too much with it. Somebody launched. Oh, there you guys are. Okay. Nod dog. You will pay for meddling in Lord K'avar's affairs. You guys are still on with that, huh? Come on, guards. What are you doing? Didn't you see me just get struck by an arrow there? Like, seriously? Like, the guy literally sends people to kill us, but somehow we can ally ourselves with him. Which is pretty much the stupidest thing I've ever heard of, but oh well. Some people just like being a certain way, you know? Anyhow, that was that. Look at all the bodies that I'm laying out in Koegria. Poor Koegria. Look at that. Just look at the sheer amount of bodies that are left behind. All because of me. Well, all because of Lord K'avar, actually, but yeah. Look at all the trouble that I brought to this nice little peaceful town. So, I'll make a healthy decision and just stop playing it altogether. And, yeah, until we return in Daggerfall Unity with a fresh character rerolled in the form of a mage. Pretty anticlimactic for a final video, but yeah, it is what it is. I don't know what I'm going to play after this. Of course, I will continue covering Delta Force 2, but as far as Daggerfall is concerned, I'll probably take a month or two long break from it. A healthy break, not a short break either, because I want to be, you know, eager to go and explore these dungeons again, because right now I'm getting sort of sick and tired of them. So yeah, thank you so much for sticking around to the end of the entire series. Even though this was not Daggerfall Unity and played on the DOSBox, this is the original Daggerfall experience as I have experienced it. And thank you for so much, so very much for being a part of it. All of the people who are watching this have been an invaluable part of the experience as well. So thank you. Thank you for bringing this into my life. You guys too. You guys gathering around me. So yeah, I will see you back in Daggerfall Unity sometime within the next few months. Until then, take care, farewell, take care of yourselves and yours. Fear thee well, fellow things. Okay, you're getting a little too close there, buddy.